Hey, welcome back. My name is Alex. I'm a freelance videographer and filmmaker, and today we are taking a look at NCT 127's favorite. It just came out. I don't know how I missed it. As always, I read the lyrics, but I didn't listen to the song quite yet. This is definitely really interesting. I really like their sticker music video. Oh, okay. That was a cool transition. We get a little glimpse of his fangs right there. I wonder if this mouth is CGI or if it's like a physical thing. Because they have this really thin camera lens and you can make a little mold of a mouth and just squish it. I don't know. It's a cool transition though. It's a really cool transition. And this is different. This is like the first time I've seen a ring light used in a music video. They're super common in the YouTube world. I've just never seen it in a music video. There's one right there. It's like a circular light and it'll give you this reflection. Your eyes are pretty cool because whatever light you throw at it is the light that's gonna get reflected in your eyes. So they give this nice, like really stylized look. And then because the light is right in front of your face, everything is nice and even and pretty. Like makeup YouTubers use this a lot. Ooh. I wasn't expecting the song to sound like this. Oh, whoa. Oh, wow. There's so much going on. They have a nice LED strip going everywhere and that gets these nice reflections on the ceiling. Everything is reflective and it gives this really cool look. And they even got a little bit of like flashing lights every now and then. That looks like such a cool set. Obviously this is the case, but I like how the editing kind of like flows with the song. Not that like their cuts line up, but like the style matches. Just like adding like little small stuff like that. And I don't know how to explain it. Oh, wow. Whoa. Okay, whoa, there's, what? Gonna be one of those videos, huh? This part looks super cool. I'm guessing this is in front of one of those LED walls. That just looks amazing. Like they probably built this rock and then the rest of this is like a combination of the LED wall and like CGI. But like, do you understand what I'm trying to say with editing? Like it's like really fun, like the beat. I don't know. Lots of match cuts. This, the camera robot. Oh, yes. Oh my god, what even? As always, they are rock solid with all of their transitions. They're using this camera robot to like prep the transitions and make everything flow very nicely. But even like small transitions like this, where he goes from the bathroom floor to standing up, that looks so cool. The world just like warps around it. Too. It's like this really interesting stylized look. And again with the camera robot, and then it goes into a masking transition, right? And it gets all like distorted and crazy. This is the kind of stuff you see in like Western music videos. So it's really cool that we're seeing like some of that overlap going on. It looks so good. Yes. Yes. They're using a lot of those masking transitions. Ooh. Okay. Oh, I've noticed that they use this like warping transition quite a bit. It's like the camera's inside of a sphere, kind of. Look at how good he looks. He looks nice and dramatic. This is like side lighting, so the light is just coming from the side of his face to get this nice shadow. And the camera's just revolving around him and focusing on the bite. And that should just be makeup. I don't think that they would do that with CGI. I think that's makeup. I love this forest. This forest looks so cool. We've seen it a couple times. And then a real quick like jump into the bite. Ah, amazing. I'd like it. Oh, I bet you. What? I bet you the contrast between them dancing in that red room versus this white room isn't an accident. Maybe it's a before and after, like they're vampires in the red room and not in the white room, but that distinction between the two rooms is definitely there. This little like break in their dancing, it's just all glitchy and cool looking. And... ooh, I definitely like the camera robot. Ooh. They got the cat eyes going on. That's cool. You can see they changed the look of the pupil. I just love all of like the little glitchiness, like the like real fast cuts. Oh, that looks beautiful. Oh, so does that. Wow. Nice sky transition. Okay. So that is confirmation that like everything is using this LED wall. I don't want to like forget this scene, but this bathroom scene looks amazing. He looks like a doll, like a porcelain doll. Like his skin looks amazing, but they have just this one light, this real harsh light getting this shadow right here. It's all nice and moody and dramatic. It's one thing about this music video with them being vampires, they can do like the moody dramatic thing because it fits the vampire image. Like this, amazing. That LED wall like just opens up the realm of possibility for so much. Then of course the transition. Oh. Yes, I like this bathroom scene. Like the look of it looks amazing. Ooh. That little shot is nice. All of the camera movements here. Wow. I like this really stylized scene. The light is just blooming and they're using like a star filter on the lens to get these like light streaks. It looks very like 80s pop. And then this scene, like he is in the stars now. And then they like add stars on top of him. They're using that same star filter. Like it looks amazing. Yes. Oh, they're in a diner now? Yes, finally. I was waiting for this forest. Ooh. The forest is amazing because it's just like depth. Like it's so much depth because you have all of these branches and everything just like going as far back as you can see. It looks so good. And the flashing lights too. And then this, the camera robot, you can really see like its capabilities, like why it would be useful. Okay, with the match cuts. Ooh. So what happened with his heart? Yes. They are really, really good with the match cuts. How can I not want you, my heart, when you touch, I shiver. Okay, so that's why they're showing the heart. So beautiful. I love these like CGI transitions, like they flow so smooth. And then they enhance all of their match cuts too, like that. So they changed up the colors of everything. Okay. Oh, yes. I'm talking about like layers and depth. So aside from like atmospheric fog, which will work really well with your lights and give you like some depth in the background, they have like spooky fog. It fits with the theme of like vampires and like horror, but they have that fog on the ground so that it'll like kick up when they're dancing. Yes, oh my God. Oh. Wow. That is so beautiful. Oh my God. Look at that. I love that so much. All of those butterflies, they're so gorgeous. I like that everything is like monochromatic. Everything is like kind of gray. One thing that's super cool about the LED screens is that you can program this in there. So you can have all of these butterflies go on the screen behind you, like on cue. And then in your editing, you just have to add the butterflies in front of them. It's like really cool stuff. It looks amazing. Wow, so many of them. Did they all turn into one? What? Oh. What? Okay, so did the butterflies turn into flower petals? It seems like it, right? I love the flowers just growing from the ground. All of the flashing lights gets that real intensity. Yes. It's such a contrast between these two scenes. And them adding in this like really nice lens flare from the light behind them, it really just like solidifies like this is like actually happening instead of them just being on a platform in front of a screen. You have to add in elements to like ground your world and immerse the viewer. So lens flares definitely do that. Ooh. Wow. Oh my God. compared to the other one. This one is so simple. It looks amazing. There's just like some smoke behind him. It's like a sunset. It looks really good. It's really just the colors and the fact that like his skin looks so beautiful. Like he is lit up like so amazing and he just pops out. But this, oh wow. The contrast between the red and all of the grays, like the red really just stands out. And then adding in the smoke with the flower petals, like whoa, he's really just turning into flower petals. Ooh, okay. Now he's in a void. They're all in a void. Okay, so that's back to being red. It's a nice transition. Okay. So is that part of the void or no? Oh, this, I like this because they're using a really high intensity ProMist filter. You can see that he's just a little blurry, and that's because the ProMist filter blooms the highlights, but the higher the intensity, the more it'll bloom. So you can see like all of the blooming right here on this window. I don't know, it makes it look really, really retro and gives us a really cool look. Oh, it looks so good. I like the reflectiveness right there. Okay. Got more flashing lights to bring up that intensity yet again. So is this an aftermath? Or it was all just like really beautiful imagery and like all implied, like it's all up for interpretation, but I wanted to see some vampires. I want to give a big thank you to all my Patreon supporters, specifically Charity, Elizabeth, Jemmy, Kimberly, Lisa, Lucas, Melissa, Miss Heju, and Victoria. If you're not already subscribed, then go do that, and all right, all right.